Hey, and welcome back to another Darkfall review. So today we're going to be reviewing this all-in-one 3D printer by Easy3D. I ordered this a couple of weeks ago from GearBest and it's just arrived today, so I'm excited to give this a try and see how it works. But yeah, so let's jump right in. They provide quite a few things. We have the power supply, an instruction manual. We also have a USB transfer cable, so you can plug this straight into your computer. We also have a screwdriver to level the bed, a card reader, and also an SD card with software on it. But once you get it, there's not really much setup. You just need to remove a couple of clips, and then you're good to go. So on the back, we have the feeding button. We also have the SD card slot, the slot for the USB cable, and also the power cable. These are the files on the SD card. We have a couple of videos to show you how to use the machine and how to use the software. You also have the software itself, but for me, it was corrupted and it didn't work. So I had to use the copy of Cura that they provided and just installed this. So if this is the first time that you've ever used slicing software, don't worry, there's not much we need to change. You do need to change maybe the filament size and the diameter of the nozzle. Now you can go ahead and load in your model. They provide a model for you, just drag and drop. So as you can see, this is the model that they provided for us. It's pretty cool. It's kind of a vase. But I'm going to go to file. I'm just going to clear this. It's a good model, but I want to use our own model. So get rid of that. Go to load. Find where you saved all your STL files. Now, for anyone who uses Blender, you'll know straight away who this is. But for those of you who don't, this is maybe a mascot of Blender. When it loads, I thought, since this is the first time I've had a 3D printer and I use Blender all the time, why not print it. So as you can see, it's the Suzanne monkey head, and right now it's in layers, so we can see what layers, see how it looks in the layers. It's very small, so we'll increase that as well. Let's go ahead and change this to normal view. This is how it looks. Looks pretty good. Now we have a bunch of tools here. I'm just going to scale this up, change this value, and since it's uniform scaled, if I change it on one axis, it'll change it on all of them. Now we just need to wait for it to update and tell us how long it'll take, and also how much filament it's going to use. So that's not too bad. I mean, if it's bigger, it would take longer. But one of the problems, if we can see the ears here, it's going to have some trouble with overhang. So what I did was I went to support and just added everywhere. Now it's going to support the ears. Also going to add some more time to the print time and also add some more filament. It's definitely worth having so the ears don't fall off or not print correctly. But once you're happy with everything, we can save this to the SD card and go ahead to print it. The supports, but there's still some jagged bits we need to remove. But once we've smoothed this out and also painted it, I think it'll look really good. I mean, I'm impressed with it already. So if you guys want to pick this printer up too, this I ordered mine from GearBest. It was $145.54, free delivery, and it took about 20 days to be delivered from China. So I mean, it didn't take too long. I've had stuff take longer. You can choose which plug you want as well, depending on where you live, so you can check out all the stats. We have some more information as well on the page, shows you how to use it and some more things. But overall, I'm really impressed with this. Since it's my first 3D printer, I'm really happy with it. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this review. If you did, be sure to give it a like. And as always, thanks for watching.